listen to this.
Whenever life gets you down, Mrs. Brown, and things seem hard or tough, and people are stupid, obnoxious or daft, and you feel that you've had quite enough.
All right, so it's been a year and a half since my son and I, a little more than a year and a half actually, since my son and I converted his van into a home, and he's back. He's back in Georgia, and we've done some improvements and some modifications, so let's take a look. And there he is. All right.
How's it going?
Yeah, it's going good. Welcome back.
Yeah.
All right. So what do we do?
Well, since the very beginning, a lot of things have changed, I guess. Curtains I added right away. That was something I did right out of the gate that you guys probably didn't see. I also added, I have like a carpet in the bottom.
That's cool.
So we also took apart all the plumbing, cleaned, flushed that entire system with bleach.
Because of mold buildup.
Yeah, mold built up over a little bit over time.
Yeah.
And it was nice to get it all taken apart and cleaned. What else? Do you want to come in?
Yeah.
So yeah, we did armor all in the front to clean everything up and make it nice and shiny. We cut a little notch out here for electronics, to add electronics in. Redid a little bit of paint here and there. Just touch-ups. The white paint too, especially, got a little dirty. So redid some of the white paint. What else?
Paper towel holder.
Oh yeah, yep. Moved the paper towel holder up to here. It was down here. And then a dry erase board.
Yep.
Power washed as well. Power. So the dirt along the side, that was all cleaned up. The dirt in the tires, all the
brake dust.
The brake dust.
They were filthy. Yep. But that's not the big improvement.
No, it's not.
No, the big improvement is we added a basement. So, wow, holy cow, look at this.
Yeah, I needed the extra space. It was a little cramped, so adding a basement really gave me a little more freedom.
Holy cow. Oh, you got a new kitchen even?
Well, I wanted more storage for my food.
Right,
and then
right.
To have a full-size sink to do dishes.
Yep, you won't have to bleach that one. Holy cow, you got a computer, you got a lounge chair.
Yeah, I wanted to lounge a little bit more.
Right. So you really opened it up. Big screen TV, I see.
I do.
Damn.
I have a TV now.
You did good. Like, you know, I guess my carpenter skills really rubbed off on you.
Well.
Excellent.
it's one of those things where when you have a little bit of space, then you just want to expand it.
Right,
so it
right. And you got a bedroom back here. My God. Jeez. So you oh, wow. Look at that.
Yeah, full-size bed.
Holy cow. Yeah. You know, the van doesn't look that big from the outside, but you know what? It's very misleading.
Well, you know, it has to do with perspective and angles.
Yeah, it really does. Yep, and lighting. So,
yeah.
Okay, well, welcome home.
Yeah, thanks.
Beautiful.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, all right.
Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour. That's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned a sun that is the source of all our power. The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at a million miles a day. In an outer spiral arm at 40,000 miles an hour of the galaxy we call the Milky Way. Our galaxy itself contains 100 billion stars. It's 100,000 light years side to side. It bulges in the middle, 16,000 light years thick, but out by us it's just 3,000 light years wide. We're 30,000 light years from galactic central point. We go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is only one of millions of billions in this amazing and expanding universe. Keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can whiz. as fast as it can go, the speed of light, you know, 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely is your birth. And pray that there's intelligent life somewhere up in space, 'cause there's bugger all down here on Earth.
Can we have your liver then?